high. Look at this seat, alright? This is, the seat that Edmund will be sitting on, and I'm gonna dirty with my butt first, so that when he sits, he can feel my butt. He's gonna bring home my butt all the way back to Netherlands. So I can't wait for this to start. I'm so excited. I wish all of you can be here, but you know what? I'm just gonna let you guys see what is it all about, alright? I'll see you guys in a bit.
Okay, everybody have a mental.
No, not really, because he likes to talk to the players. So I just I was in his office for a different matter. I was talking about my testimonial game in Holland. That's that was on the 3rd of August, and I needed to speak to him for the availability for some players. And he's going to manage that game of my team in that on the 3rd of August. So we're just talking a little bit and. To be fair, a lot of players and a lot of fans have said, okay, man, you can't stop. And if I went in the city center, then people stop you and everything. Oh, come on, you have to play another year. A lot of letters also from Asia, they came in. So you tell that, and at a certain point you said, sometimes you're even gonna doubt if you make the right decision. That was the only thing. So no big U-turn whatsoever. I think they scouted him for a long time. I think they know that I was not going to play forever. So there was a certain point that you had to stop. So they checked him out, and I think they made a choice to sign him. Of course, he's a little bit younger than me. But he's already proved himself in certain finals. He won the UEFA Cup final with Atletico Madrid, and let's hope he does well for United.
Sometimes he's happy.
It happened about 261 times that he started shouting all the time. So there's 4 times we were winning by at least 3 goals to nil when we went
against Tottenham, right? This one time as well.
No, of course. The manager is the manager. He has certain qualities. He got the coaching staff for during the week, and of course during the match days. He's in charge, of course. And when something not goes well, he lets you know that something has to change. But most of the time, honestly, 95% it's all good. And luckily, we win a lot of games.
That's right.
So we. Be fortunate that we don't have to listen too much to what he has to say.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I think it's difficult because you got different leagues. You got the Champions League and the Premiership. And the Premiership is you need a lot of strength also to play against teams who play a different type of football than normal. Let's say a Bolton, a Blackburn, or a Stoke. Even City have a lot of big players, so if you want to be successful in England, you need a certain type of player. And okay, the trick is to combine that with players who can make a difference on the pitch with their footballing qualities. And so far he made two new outfield players. He bought two new outfield players with Essie Young and Jones. And hopefully one more, and it needs a lot of practice on the training ground, of course, to get the team organized again. Scholes, he retired, and Gary a little longer already, so it's going to be a change in how the team is going to look like, but I'm sure it's going to be confident that it's going to be all well. I think you can name a lot of regrets, finals that you lost, not winning anything with your national team, moves you didn't make or you made too late, and the thing that I enjoyed most is of course winning, and especially the big prizes, the big trophies, and that I won the Champions League in '95 at Ajax, and luckily I was able to win it again in 2008 with United. I'm glad you noticed that it's a tough life to be a football player. it's a great life. It's you work with a lot of young guys around you. You can train outside. You work outside. Sometimes it rains a lot in Manchester, but sometimes the sun shines, and just being outdoors is great. And you had a manager who was a lot of big qualities, and being able to make a team better and make better players better. The friendship you make with players, not only here at United but also at previous teams or at Ajax, already like a long time ago, 20 years. But I'm still friends with a lot of those players. So yeah, it's been great. I think you got a couple of obvious choices, of course. Peter Cech is a very good goalkeeper. He's been all quite on a high level for the 6-7 years that he's been in England with Chelsea. They won a couple of trophies. When we slipped up, they managed to get a hold on the title. And he's good. I like Pepe Reina. And hopefully there are going to be some English goalkeepers coming through. For the moment, there's some you got more foreign goalkeepers there, but hopefully for England, you're going to get some young goalkeepers also. I think you make a lot of saves over your career, of course. some win you a game or get you a point or get you 3 points. But I think the save that sticks out the most, I think, is the penalty save against Anelka in 2008. It's just a great feeling to make a save and the game is finished. So there's not a rebound or something, not another penalty. You just boom, finished, and you won the Champions League with that one. So that's been not been the most spectacular save, but probably the most important one. I don't know. I did some coaching badge course last year in Manchester together with some other players, and I enjoy that. But at the moment, just wanna take it easy a little bit more, focus a little bit on different things in life, and maybe in a year time when you really really miss football, then maybe you come back or say in a coaching role or maybe in management or commercial or. It's been a big part of your life, football, of course. So it's probably gonna be the same for a long time. I've been getting that question, I think, for 18 years. Always said like, who do you fear the most, and who's the best striker? And I think if you're gonna start looking at it like that, it's quite difficult for a goalkeeper to still perform. Every team you play against, you always look. Where's the threat? Where are the threats coming from? The threats coming from? Is the striker left footed or right footed? Is he strong with his head? Do they get a lot of crosses in? But like the strikers who I not struggled with, but didn't really like, I think it was Ronaldo, Brazilian Ronaldo. I played with Filippo Inzaghi, Juventus. He just he's a typical just goal scorer. He just hangs around, and every little ball that's like a rebound or an offside or something is always there.
Never offside.
He's 9 times offside, and 10 times he's not going to put a flag up in his course. But I like Van Nistelrooy. I played him a long time, not so long with United, but with Holland I played a long time with him. Really like him also. From my boyhood on, I like you too. I'm not that fussy about music, to be fair. Even if the iPod is on from Patrice, and sometimes there are some not so good songs or
what songs does he play? That's not so good.
No, he plays a nice mix, to be fair. He caters for the old.
Diplomatically
correct. He caters for the old and for the young. Sometimes the music for the young, it's not my music anymore. So sometimes I just want to walk past it, just press next song.
Are you gonna kiss it?
I did already. 4 times.